Greetings, Earthlings. Well, here we are in the studio, and what I'm going to do now is I'm going to try a new format for the next few videos. I'm going to do it just like this. Open up in the studio, tell you what's coming up, and at the end of the episode, then I'll come back on and address some comments and questions. So here's the new format. If you don't like it, well, you're just going to have to suffer through it for a little while. And not... if there's something you don't like, just don't watch it. I mean, you don't have to unsubscribe like somebody did just because I put up something they didn't like. Well. Oh, well. Anyway, shop recovery number 6. Like I said, I'm going to blow through all the shop recovery videos, get them done and out of the way, and get back on the stuff that's 3 years old. So I'm going to try to burn out as... not burn out, but I don't want to burn out. I'm going to try to run through as many videos as I can here. So, ready? Too much talking. Here you go. Shop recovery number 6. Time to take care of this wall. I really gotta get a new end for this cord. We'll be right back.
yes, I will avoid the smoke. And never ignite your steel incendiary device in like fashion. Yourself. It's a theory. This one is much shorter than the rest. Okay, so the plan isn't working out quite as well as I thought it would. Because this let go, this was inside the other tube, and it bent right there at that joint, so it took this lift and curled it inward. Now I gotta curl it outward. Nice if I had a cone I could stick in there. Spread that out. But I ain't got one of them. But what I do have, a pair of earplugs. Yes, I know I could use a tractor, but where's the learning in that? I may get there. Well, guess what? That don't want to fit in there. That done dragged it into this pole. Doubts about using the tractor, because you got to come in from the side if you want to grab it in the middle, and the whole thing is just flexible and wobbly. You could come in on this end, and the only thing it's going to do is pick up this one and that one, and the rest of it's just going to want to bend. Doesn't mean I won't do it. I just want to find a way to try to get this up incrementally. Hoping that these pipes will dig into the ground once you get them up, and they'll kind of ratchet themselves and work down the line and bring it up a little bit at a time. It's a theory. That will never do. Tomorrow. Okay, on with comments. If you ever wonder why you don't see your comment on the thing, that's because what YouTube does right here. So you've got the tabs. Likely spam, 52. 52 in likely spam. That's because I haven't been in here for a while. Well, here's one issue I'd like to address. Like Harry Walker over there in Australia, you put your email address in the comment, and YouTube will always throw them in the spam folder, and I will not put those up on YouTube because you do not want to put your email address up in the comment section of YouTube. So, enough of that. Daryl Frank, thank you. I I'm glad to know that people do learn something from what I put up here. That kind of makes it worthwhile. Jay Rawson. Well, this is not a vlog. It started out as showing somebody what they bought because they lived 650 miles away. And it just kind of grew out of that. And I had a background in production, so I just kind of went with it. And it kind of evolved into what it is, and I'm just trying different things. And we'll see how it goes from there. And for all of you on the 1948 ACF Brill bus, that bus was sold to Mike Haggerty down in California. And what he's doing with it, I don't know. I've tried to call him several times, and he doesn't return a call. So, who knows? Here, I like this one. Laura C., your focus is foggy. Your focus is blurry. Blurry, help, I can't see. Bob. Well, the thing is, Bob, on that video, that was back in 2000... let's go look. March 12th, 2010. That's back when it was a Fuji Finepix still image camera in video mode and dial-up internet connection. So, yeah, you can't see. And you can't see that it was uploaded 7 years ago. Anyway, that's the story on that one. Don't worry about editing. Let it go raw. It works for others. Well, you got to remember that when I start on a job, I turn the camera on and leave it roll. So there is, on a 20-minute video, anywhere from 3 to 6 hours of video footage. If you would like to watch 3 to 6 hours of video footage, and some of it is nothing but animals walking around in the background, I could send them to you privately. So, but it would take... It takes 6 hours to upload a 20-minute video, sometimes 10 hours to upload, and that's on DSL. Project Whitey, a lot of questions. Project Whitey has fallen through, basically. It's still here. The customer has no money to put it together. I was trying to get University of Northwest Ohio to underwrite the completion of the project, and as far as this fiscal year, they weren't willing to go for it. UNOH is my alma mater. That's where I went. Back then it was called NBC Tech. So I'm still trying to see what I can do to swing something with UNOH to do some recruiting. For any of you who are into NASCAR and you want to learn how to be a pit crew, you can do that at UNOH. It's an amazing thing. Richard Fote, you wrote me a song. Well, you're welcome for me teaching you stuff, but you don't have to write a song. Smokey John used to have a 59 GMC. He can't wait till he can get another. Well, John, I happen to have one. What do you bid? Mr. Alchoa, what am I doing here?
He's me.
Was the cat under one of the walls waiting to be recovered? No, but there is still a chicken out there underneath something. I probably won't film that. Aussie Drifter. What's the diff? Matter of opinion. Oh. Coco Cabana. Steve Gauthier. No problem, dude. Back on the subject of people sending money to support Redneck Restorations, this old truck. Coco Cabana. Go there. Send it there. I will not be rebuilding the shop. Yeah, I know there's not much livestock noise anymore. Dan Sledge. And, yeah, the air compressor's broke, and we don't have 13 roosters, and the goats just aren't making noise. Don't know what to do about it. Hey, where's Danny Walker? Haven't seen him in a long time. Mr. Heavy Chevy, I don't understand algorithms either, but it's just what Darren Musty One told me. And, I don't know, he's coming up in the world. Now I gotta catch up to him. T-shirts! There's supposed to be T-shirts being made, but somebody, and you know who you are, still hasn't come through on the T-shirts yet. I got a couple samples, but when he gets it all set and ready to drop the flag on it and run with it, then we're going to go, and I'll tell you about them then. Freewheeler88, do you realize how long it takes me to read your comments? The compressor. I have a gas-powered screw compressor, which I'm using temporarily. I've got a video of getting it running after 15 years. I know. An update on Bill and Hillary. I don't have one. Well, I do have one. Bill, Hillary, they got my vote. Well, okay, thanks to all you guys for welcoming me back, and I appreciate the comments and things that you do. No, I still haven't sent out all the stickers, and there's still a stack of envelopes with stickers in them, and even with stamps on the envelopes, and I just haven't taken them down to the post office. And I got a diff cover that's got to go out, and... what else is there? That's pretty much it. If you didn't get your comment commented on or question replied to, it's because there's hundreds of these for me to go through. And after this video, I'll watch and I'll try to keep up with the previous video and do things that way. So, until the next one, for Redneck Restorations, this old truck, I'm Jeff Bradshaw.